Okay, so what we have here is the system of equations. I've just recapped what we've looked at in the previous video. So here you see the system of equations that we have here, where you see the y dash vector equals the vector f and that vector y there. Y of x zero equals y zero. So that's the system of first order differential equations. More importantly, I want you to look at the Runge-Kutta, which is much neater now. I'll print it out. So here you'll see this is the vector version of the Runge-Kutta, fourth order, in fact. And the vectors k, 2k, all of these with the brackets 1, 2, 3, they represents the k1, represent the k1, k2, k3, and k4. And the definitions are given over here. Now, we'll move on now to basically look at okay, so what I've now got here is an example of a second order initial value problem. Now, we've already done this one as well, in fact. Okay, so I'm just recapping, as I said, very quickly. So this second order differential equation can be broken down in this set of vectors. Now, I'm sorry, this set of equations. Now, we'll move on to the next stage. So now you'll see here the fourth order Runge-Kutta for this problem over here, which is the two equations z dash and y dash. And this is basically, you get the two sets of equations and the two sets of basically the values of k and the values of l. And of course, this is how we calculate. Now, what I want to do actually is, keeping this here, I want to solve an actual example of a differential equation. So that's what we're going to do. So here's an example. So you see, this is an actual second order differential equation. And y double dash plus y dash plus y equals x. And we have the conditions y of 0 equals y dash of 0 equals 0. We'll let z equal y prime. And if we do that, then of course, as I said, so clearly z prime, okay, is going to give us y and double prime. Okay, now if z prime is y double prime, so this means that this equation here, okay, will become, in fact, z prime plus, we'll have the z itself, plus we'll have y, and all of that is equal to x, in fact. Okay, and we can rearrange the equation and get z prime is equal to x minus z minus y. So we've got this first order equation, and we've got the first one that we have above, which is y prime is equal to z. So now we've got our basically our system, our first order system of equations. Let me box that. And of course, the initial conditions. Now look, y of 0 equals 0. So that means that we have here, we'll have along with side here, y of 0 equals, equals 0. And now z prime is really, y dash is z. So that means that we'll have z of 0 equals 0 as well. So now we've got our full system. So that they're, of course, connected. Sorry, let me just put them all together. So now we're ready to basically go and apply the Runge-Kutta to this. So I'll just clean this up a little bit. So there, I've cleaned it up a little bit. So there you see that's our system. Now, we'll use the fourth order Runge-Kutta with h equals 0.1. And we're going to try to see how we can calculate y of 0.1, in fact. So let's actually start calculating some of the values now. So the first thing we'll see is k1. K1 is h times z of 0, which is, of course, equal to 0. So that's easy to see that, OK? Next, then we'll calculate L1. So L1 is h times f of x0, y0, z0. So remember, f in this case, let me just on the side here show you that basically, you see, for the z equation, there are two different equations that we have here, remember. So for the z equation, we have this over here. I'm sorry. Okay, so for the z equation, we've got this. Okay, and for the y equation, this is our function. So these are the two functions that we'll be basically working with. So now, since k is associated with, one second now. So here you'll see 0 minus 0 minus 0 because x0, y0, z0 is all 0. So remember, this f is basically this here that you see here. This, I'm going to box it. There, that basically is the f of x0, y0. So you just substitute in x0, y0, z0 in here, and that gives us a 0. So in this way, we as we proceed in the same way, we can calculate k2 and all the remaining. So as we do that, you can see the k2 here, z0 plus l1 over 2. That's also going to be 0 because remember, L1 is 0 and Z0 is 0 as well. So a lot of these turning out to be 0. But anyway, there you'll see now Y0 plus K1 over 2. Okay, K1 is 0. So again, you'll end up with 0 here. So anyway, the first non-zero value turns up here, which is the L2. And similarly, now as we bring that in here, all these calculations for the Ks and the Ls, once we have these, we are now in a position to actually start calculating the first iteration. So let's remember, of course, we're going to be, for the y, we're using this, essentially, this formula here. So the k's will all end up going inside here. Okay? So let's, so basically, again, let me just reiterate. So once we calculate the z1 value, as we put it in here, now the z1, of course, remember, this completes it. So what's happening is we've taken this system. This is a system that's for any size of differential equation, possibly, or any system of differential equations. So you can take a ninth order differential equation, have nine first order differential equations, and it will still be this Runge cutoff fourth order that you'll be applying. So as an example here, the second order applied to this, this is the formula applied to it. This is an actual example, and this is the actual calculation for it. Now let's look at what are these results? What are they telling us? Remember, remember here that in this particular instance, if I am to just say, for instance, here, the y1 is pretty straightforward. That's just the value of y. But what is this value of z telling us, really? So if you think about it, z is actually y prime. So this means that what this is telling us is that, well, look, it's telling us that the y at 0.1, okay, is this value. This value that you see here. Okay, and z, then what is this z1 telling us? Well, it's telling us that y dash, okay, at 0.1 approximately is in fact this value. This is the result that we actually end up with. As you can see, this is how you actually interpret your answers as to what is this value of z. Because of course the y is, fair enough, that's the solution to the differential equation. Because remember, we started with this differential equation, so everything you see here is, there's y's, okay? There's y's everywhere. So these y's, in fact, the original differential equation is this one. So okay, there was no z, we introduced the z, okay? So therefore, but the z does provide us with interesting information. It's basically telling us what is the derivative at 0.1. So I hope this helps you to understand how the Runge-Kutta system can be used to solve various examples. Thank you.